All right, we're ready to start. Day 2 of playing 12. By yours truly. So yeah, last time we finished the episode 1. It says it's completed now, yeah. Now we get to the new stuff. Really, really fun things. Episode 2, The Sunken City. Once a great civilization now sunken deep below. Earth to live again. Just gonna try to rush some of the levels because I know that my level is so long that I'm gonna get through it. It's gonna take some effort. Another nice tunnel going through. Technomagical Transfusion, D2M1. This map is made by Fairweather. Using this texture set called Crate CR8. That's how you pronounce it. But it's a pretty cool texture set for base. It's a lot of brown, like Quake should be. Some nice detail with monitors and stuff. Giving it a little bit of contrast. So the episode 2 is heavily based on like underwater stuff and lost like Aztec or Mayan stuff. But first level is always a base. Reference here. Something, something. Fair weather. Distraction there, taking a lot of damage. Huh. Yeah, in this episode you get this weapon really early, which is pretty nice. You trust the rotary shotgun. Whoops. That's not good. It's an area back there, but it's a secret, I think. I forgot how to get. Small mistake there. I really love how much action there is on the first level. Just get straight to it. No bullshit. That shambler. Almost at all kills, but I'm missing the secrets. Doing really bad. That front. Oh well. Sometimes when you just start wandering around, it's hard to keep track where you've been. There is our exit portal. I didn't find any secrets. Should at least showcase one of them. I can find one. I know there's a really cool sequence where you get a more powerful weapon to start with. Just some random facts of lore. These little pipe details and the computers. Nice. That's where we started. Forget this badly. It's not been a long time since I played this. I went for all the secrets. Hi Gorenia. Do you remember any secrets on this map? Because I don't freaking know. Just lost trying to find at least one. Skipped it. Yeah, this is pretty new anyways. Pretty annoying that the edge friction is a thing in Quake 1. It's jumping really hard. There we go. Hi DJ. Just starting. Finished the first map of the episode 2. Just looking for some secrets because I had to find at least one. This is a really cool base map to start episode 2. Just gonna move on. I really have to get the maps finished. I don't want to split the three different streams. Yeah, that was the first map. I should also check the intermission cameras after finishing every map. Showcase all the cool angles. Cat Swim Two Birds. B2M2 by Justly. Now we get this ancient rocky temple type of thing that episode 2 is going for. Here's a secret that I remember. It's actually clipped. I didn't even realize. Usually you get climb up. It's kind of weird. I do it from Doom. What are you guys up to? How's your day been? Like I said before, water is more common in episode 2 levels. Hi Alex. And Alex said the musics that you hear in the background in every level. Just metal. Well, I'm looking forward to that. So far, your soundtrack is really amazing. decided to balance the audio a little bit different now, so the music is much more from. That's an easy secret. Yeah, that's great. Good to hear, literally. Also, hi, Henry. Simple but pretty effective rooms, fun staircases and stuff. Oh, nails. Let's not forget those. Surprise leap by the fiend. Hi Pyro. Oh, and hi Mobiblock. I didn't notice your name there. it all kind of blended with Alex's name. And I hate how the Twitch is like handling the usernames. But yeah, hi anyways. Only afford to take a glance at the chat from time to time. Still training my eye or reading the Twitch. Some of the later levels that are on this episode, I have not even played those yet, so it will be blind for me. to some extent at least. Pretty nice how the layout loops around the center courtyard or whatever this is called. Yeah, just the layout. Finally we get the grenade launcher here. A lot of monsters set up some balconies trying to snipe you. I wonder what this is. There's a mega health over there at least. Power-up, bro. Okay, I'll return for that secret to see if I can make it after I clear everything. That secret I know. There we go. That was a nice surprise. This is the actual exit of the level. How do I get back? There was like a ledge where we can climb. Yeah. I'm gonna go see that button again. Grab some extra supplies while at it. Oh, I see. Your reward is more monsters. Yeah, even I'm guilty of making stuff like that. That's life. 7 out of 10. That's fine. We can live with that secret code. That didn't happen. Just to save time. To be fair, I was reading chat while I was jumping forward. Nice angles, covering the entire map. Pale Sun E2M3. This was made by Marky, and he made the block out and the gameplay, but then Paul took the map and made it look beautiful and arted it with textures and more geo. So this is pretty special map on the episode 2. Extremely cool rooms. And this soundtrack is great as well on this level. I Probably my second favorite from episode 2. Here we get our favorite tool again. I've heard that you've been asking for clears quite a while from different people, etc. Also, hi, welcome to the, well, playthrough. These statues are absolutely beautiful. They were made by Bal. There's a secret that you need something extra for to be able to get in. There's a fiend up there. Kind of hard to get them through that crate. Red armor there. we can use this power up to get this secret. Because now we are swimming faster, we can actually reach that in time. Oh yeah, and this fish head fountains are pretty cool as well. Really, really cool. The lighting is so cool. Damn. This is like some of the best corridors ever made in Quake. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Full 3D art pipeline. Shortcut. Is there a thing here? I misremember. I guess I did. Oh. Wait, I'm lost again now. Thanks for the follow, Nelson. And thanks for the follow, setup.
Zeta-byte is now following.
Okay, now we get to go to the underwater parts again. Some swimming. Crystals are pretty cool as well. Our new enemy. they're called constructs. That shoot projectile forward, and when you do enough damage to them, they will go to this kamikaze mode and fly towards you. And explode really hard.
Underscore is now following.
Thanks for the follow. Keep up. Hiya. What brings you around here to watch some Quake? Maps specifically. It's gonna take a while until I get to my map, but yeah, it is gonna be pretty fun to talk about that. Absolutely fantastic rooms. Okay, before I do this part, I'm gonna look for some secrets. Gun and some ammo over there, but where is the path? That's the question. It's right over here. Completely forgot. I don't want to lose any of my red armor. Yeah, warp spasm is great. Just have to have a pretty good fortitude, the mindset for it. Dang. There goes my red armor. To save that for later. I'm doing really stupid decisions.
Huh.
I want to get the LT as well. Is it here? I know. I just wanted the cells. Yeah, that's the third map by Marky and Paul. Oh yeah, this room has some really cool details. Scaled up the statues. The decision to add clear, so I think that's completely up to Fairweather. I don't mind. If we get something like that to play around with, then sure, I can use them in some creative ways. Oh, hi Void Force. On to the next map. This is my favorite music track from this episode. It's so good. But we should voyage so far. It's the map name. B2M4. By Bal. See if this jump is possible. I guess it's not. Okay, moving on. I'm not gonna spend millions of years doing trick jumps. Huh. I like how this is just a corridor that you move through, but it's like detailed as if there's a temple where you could get inside and stuff. In a map that I would make, I would have like hundreds of different uses for all of these details. And the sunset is really nice. You'll have quite a bit of ammo if you play all the maps through without restarting your inventory. I'm sorry for disrupting the ogre. Here's our new guy. They're called Brutes. They have a grenade launcher that shoots 3 grenades in a volley. And they shoot twice with each attack they do. They're really dangerous if you let them spam the area with grenades. Oh yeah, that's the unfortunate part when updating Quake. If you have saves that are currently on the maps that have been changed, then you lose all your equipment. The only real way you could avoid that is to like skip to another level that doesn't get any changes and save there. And then take that save and change the level back to where you were. Or you can just give yourself enough ammo that you think you had with the cheat code. Back there? I don't remember. Well, I guess we will find out because I fell down. Nope. Yeah, hi Dennis. Yeah, this track is my favorite from the episode 2. It's so good. Thank you. a really cool fight on this room. It's a simple room, but it's still fun to move around and change the floors. Need to play more with the grenades. Get to spend them. Another thunderbolt. Nice secret. Is there anything else back here? I guess not. I can try to get to the mailbox. Nice reuse of that pillar, making it function as another turret. Yeah, Ranger is Paul's mailman. That's true.
Thank you.
What are you floating around there? Those slopes. Yeah, I said that this music track reminds me of like the Doom. Was it like Final Doom, I think? Final Doom readme music? From Plutonia? Whatever the track is called. It's very similar to that. I should find it and link it to you, Alex, so you can hear what I mean. Because it's pretty funny how it has that same type of melody. Usually by this point we would have the new weapon, but I think I missed it. The place where you can get up. Yeah, I don't think so. First key. Oh, he's stuck on the thing. Interesting. By the way, why doesn't this open? Is there a bug maybe? Oh no, wait, it's this way, right? Yeah, I have to go down here. Huh. so cool. Easy to take down the Chandler at the distance, but yeah. There was enough monsters to fight on this side as well. I have more nails here. That fiend can stay down there, or maybe not. Yeah. Maybe I missed something else here as well, so yeah, there's some nails. As well do a round around here. There's definitely something there, cells. The pathway. I guess I'll go forward. Yeah. nice spawn surprise. There's the real exit of the level, but this level has the secret exit. Now I just need to go around and find it. I wish I could remember all these paths, go all around. Okay, here's the shortcut. Make that jump. Okay, looking around we go. Well, I still missed the new weapon, which would have been nice to have. Yeah, I think I've spent enough time on this map anyway, so next up is the secret level of episode 2. Nice chunky 30 minutes that you can spend on this map looking around. Absolutely beautiful. Oh yeah, I forgot the mailbox. I could have just no clipped around there and see. Show it off. Yeah, that's my brain being forgetful. May and over matter. What's the map name? E2M9. This map is made by Greenwood. And it has a lot of fires. I mean, torches and stuff like that around the buildings. It's a pretty epic sight when you fall down. It's okay, I can watch and check it out later. Mm. the absolute amazing amount of torches. I really wish I had a new weapon for these guys. Ah, I got stuck. Deserve to take that hit. That's an interesting statement, Orc. I'm sure there's a lot of people who agree with you. Yeah, he's a legend. But one of the few people who you can call legend. Go fishing. That's nice, Alex. I think I've heard you talk about that before, a long time ago. They're all pretty cool dudes. Level-headed people. A really nasty surprise with the brutes on both sides. If you're not careful, you're gonna eat so many grenades. You should be able to get the new weapon soon. I think I remember where you can get one. Missed that stuff all over there. I don't want to go back there. Unless there was a shortcut over here. Huh. I heard something lower, but I'm not sure. Oh yes, there is. Secrets on this floor. I think there's a secret here, right? Oh, there we go. Now we're gonna cook. Guess what this weapon does? It's like a really powerful railgun. A secret. Just slightly offset the wall. This is a really funky fight that we are going to get into. To the kamikaze. There we go. That's almost everything in this level. Except of course the secrets that I missed. This is way back, yeah. There's an even nicer center print saying that. All these ammo pickups are hidden pretty well in the corners. Full 100 rockets already. Might be helpful. Let's go. That shot looks so cool. The temple. Stir fry Medusa. E2M5, and this is by Airweather again. They made quite a few levels for the second episode because we were lacking maps that need to fill the slots that we had. this one is one of the shorter levels in the episode. But it's still pretty beautiful. And fun to play. This is where you would get this weapon first time if you don't find it in any secrets. But you need the silver key first. That can wait for a bit. One little extra area that we have to do first. It's pretty dark in here, so hard to see where to move. Secret within a secret. Nicely the corridor ambush. There's a little hidden pathway here. A secret within a secret within a secret. That's how it is. Now we can go through the gate that we saw earlier. Small secret over here. There's a teleport that's pretty hard to see, but this takes you up the up with the teleport. I mean the lift. Anyone looking forward for 12 gem? Making maps for 12? The Brocks? Rotary shotgun and the railgun? And the Berserk power up? Like so many cool ideas that people could do. Hopefully we get that set up sooner rather than later. It's so cool to see what people come up with. Yeah, exactly, Henry. Speaking of Berserk power, Yeah, it was in the trailer. A pretty efficient way to kill them. Just line every monster with the brute and just rail. Just look at him. Such a beautiful chunky bar. Yeah, the knockback doesn't really work flying enemies. I mean, it can be programmed, I think. Like physics. Yeah, sleep well. We're making good progress on this level. Almost done with it. I'm thinking like I might not have time to play through my map. It's gonna be like 3 hours, and then I'm at the start of my map, and it's not gonna go well if I'm tired to play. It'd be much better to save it for the last time, I think. Final thing to do. No health in this room, which is really mean. I think I got both of them with 3 shots. Yeah. Here's a secret that you can get at least. Huh. much needed armor. I took so much damage, what? I thought I was like really healthy for that fight. Careful this time. I missed three secrets, but yeah, this is the end. It's a nice less than 15 minute map. Really smooth, nice combat setups, nice power-ups. Using the railgun is really fun. Well, it's called the Crystal Lance, but I call it railgun every time. Can't get over that. Yeah, this is very similar to the D1 M5 that you made. A similar flow, similar fight setups and stuff like that. Just slightly different. Waters below, E2M6, IJCR. Now this map might take a while since I've only tested this a little bit. I don't remember much of it. So yeah, it's gonna be a learning experience. Crystal, huh? I like how the water is in the sky. All the waterfalls are flowing up instead down. I don't know if that makes much sense, how the water is flowing up from this hill, but yeah, it's a cool effect. Thank you. secret on top of our health. More underwater swimming. This level, these fish things are spawning more fish like that, yeah. Finish it. Oh, maybe not. Damn it. I just wanted the rail one spawn. Jumped on that one. Now this is where the map shifts a little bit in its style. To the underwater valley. The terrain is a bit wonky here, you can get stuck if you're not careful. But that's standard Quake stuff. The engine is pretty old, so it doesn't handle player movement perfectly. Random buttons by accident. Those destructible cages are pretty funny and kinda cool at the same time. The explosions make them. It's pretty fun. Need the other key. There. Well, I almost missed the trigger. It's kind of annoying when you have a secret area and you miss the part that gives you the secret. I already messed this up, I guess I did. No, not quite. Still made it. They were not on the previous versions? Was it added to the latest one? that's how you get in here. That's a nice, nice way to use the environment. Some triple and quad hits there. Did they not drop attacks? We need more keys. Nice. Yeah, that fruit placement is really nice. Just standing there, waiting for someone to show up. Is this broken? I was just thinking, like, there's a way to get through. Some crystal dodging there. Okay, now it was supposed to be opening, right? Let's go check if they dropped the backpacks or not. Yeah, they did not. Only two heads remain. I just leave. We're pretty far already in the episode. I missed quite a lot of areas and stuff, but let's just move on. I wanna get to at least start of my level today, and then do the third part for my map and the end map. Wow. What a hole. Yeah, in this episode you just keep on falling in holes and trying to climb back up, but you just keep falling down. That's the whole idea of Dwell. Lesser Dwellings in the Dark, E2M7, and this is by Pinchy. This is a really open-ended level where you just have to do some tasks that I have not played yet, so this is kind of blind for me. I've only seen some people play parts of it. I should have been testing this map with the other guys, but I didn't feel motivated and inspired at the time when we were getting ready to release. What do you mean every button in this level? Okay, I'll keep my eye out for those then. Oh, that's a teleporter. Makes sense. Trying to pop me. Can't get quite the angle on the foot. There we go. Now you can read. Thank you. Yeah, this is completely new to me. Yeah, just for mentioning 37. This one is even better. Panic mode, I think. Felt like you could use one of those to jump. Maybe I'm just imagining things. Is there even autosaves on this map? Because I've been just relying on the autosaves. I haven't been paying attention. I think we need to do autosave pass for these levels to make sure that they are consistent with the other levels. I supposed to do here. Yeah, I'm really confused with the layout. Can I get there? Is that what I have to do? This all the same. This looks like a fun arena. Terrible place to be in. That's it. Thank you. That's a really mean fight. There's a lot of stuff going on. Get all the resources I can get. Okay, that's fine. There's so much stuff to explore here. Hard to choose where to go. There's our big boy weapon here. Yeah, I've cleared this area. I don't blame you for getting lost in this. This is quite something. Maybe the other side now. Huh. there's nothing here, just a place where you can climb up. Guess I'm still missing like one of the platforms or something. Cold key. Haste power up here at least. No, no use. I'm just running in circles. Not that surprised. Maybe I missed something over here. doors. That's a button that you have to press. That's a lot of damage that I'm eating. I think now we can go to the exit of the map, right? We got all those messages saying it's open now. It's all of them except one. Yeah. Isn't this the accent? I guess I'm not still done. Do something else. I'm lost again. Where do I go? Yeah, the navigation on this map is pretty rough. I guess it's what it is. I don't see how you would fix it in open layout map like this. Get up there. Too much to be asked for. This upper temple area up here. Huh. Doesn't count. I need to start to save time because I need to get through this level fast. I see. Have to power up the portal. We're on the 8th out of 280 monsters killed. Should be close. Still need the gold key. Oh, it's accessible now. Nice trap. There is one over here, right? There, but somewhere close by. Not that one we have. Yeah, this. How do I open this one? Huh. would make sense that it would be on this side, but it's not. Come on. This rocket jump. Yeah, but finding that one is pretty hard. There we go. I have no idea what the normal route to here is. I just need to get to the exit, I guess. No, I'm not gonna do my map today. It's way too late. It's better to start it on a fresh stream. Thank you. How are you supposed to have enough ammo for all this stuff? At least there's like random resources around every corner. I guess it's doable. What is this, by the way? This is the route where you get the... Okay. Thingy. Oh wait, is this just extra area? With no purpose. This. I'm so ready to move on. Damn, that was only 40 minutes. With some reloading. I'm tired, exhausted. Then next time we have this 60 secrets and 1,155 kills. GG, thanks for the GG. It's a cool ammo. Well, thanks for sticking around, being my emotional support. Some background noise. Okay, I'll see if I have time tomorrow and I will finish the... Well... Hopefully I do. I just want to get this done, so I can say that I've done it. Now we go, can go watch more Smay being played. See you guys later. Bye bye.